Okay. Hello everyone, good evening. Okay, my name is Gibson. I'm the developer of AzukiSoft, and also I released this book early this year about Objective-C memory management. So this today I'm going to talk about my experiences using Bluetooth for the Aspyrus standing desk. So Aspyrus is actually a standing desk with a Bluetooth component where you can actually sync up your phone and use the phone to actually activate certain functionalities on the desk itself. And this one is actually on Indiegogo, so we already hit the target of the amount and waiting for the campaign to end. So you can see that the desk is actually one whole desk. You can put your Mac, your laptop here. So this desk is actually like a stand. You put it on your table itself. Then you can actually use the phone to control the move up and down and turn on the lights and check things like temperature sensors and presence sensors, all that kind of stuff. So what it has is Elevation, the smart app, which is only for iOS right now, reminders, tracking, and all the other functions. So first, I'll show you all the video.
Balance. We spend a lot of our lives chasing it. The balance between activity and rest, family and work. Do we have to give up one for the other? What if we could do more, even be more at the same time? The desk is the focal point of our work, where ideas are born, where things get done, goals are set. It's also where we spend a lot of our time. That's why we created Aspyrus. Aspyrus is for those who want to get the most out of their day. It is a smart, adjustable standing desk designed to keep you healthy and bridge your competing priorities seamlessly. We've crafted Aspyrus with smart features to introduce activity into an otherwise sedentary workday, ensuring that even while you're working, your health and posture are taken care of. Be it your quiet, focused work or your energetic collaboration, Aspyrus is designed to help you strike that balance and zero in on what you're doing at that moment. This is Aspyrus. It features a one-touch preset height button for a seamless transition and customizable goals to cater to your fitness level. Its reminder system gently lets you know when it's time to move, and the focus light notifies others when you need to concentrate on important tasks. All visualized in an easy-to-use mobile app, leaving you with a deeper understanding of your daily work rhythm than you've ever had before. Aspyrus helps you get the most important things done so you can focus on what really matters. We were tired of the fatigue, backaches, and constant interruptions that came with long hours in a busy office. It was difficult to get real work done, so we challenged ourselves to think of a better way to work, starting with the place we spend the most time, our desk. A year later, we are ready to share a uniquely elegant and smart sit-stand desk. Help us change work forever.
Okay, so for this talk, we actually use a lot of stuff like Objective-C, which we're still using, not Swift yet, CocoaPods, AF networking, and Core Bluetooth, which I'll discuss today with you all. So the desk actually uses a Texas Instrument controller, which is actually connected to the desk itself with a Bluetooth sensor. And because of the Bluetooth sensor, they have a lot of registers inside the sensor that we store data, and I actually have to pull the data using the Bluetooth on the phone. So what are the communication protocol that we actually use for this communication? We tried using JSON, XML, SOAP, and all that kind of stuff. But after talking to the hardware engineer, we actually realized we settled on something called Modbus. It is actually a protocol for hardware communication. So Modbus is actually a serial communication protocol. It's actually published in 1979. That is actually very old, and it's simple and robust. So it's actually used as a de facto communication standard between hardware. Yes, okay. So that means it's royalty free. That means we don't need to pay any additional fee for libraries or whatever. So that means like we hope that actually we found some open source Objective-C library that we can use to plug into the app itself. But actually we are wrong. Okay. Modbus, like, they have Objective-C libraries, but all these libraries, like, they only use TCP to communicate with hardware, so there's no Bluetooth version of it. So what we had to do, like, is we had to write our own implementation using what we have right now, and also using all the online documentation that we can find. So it was a bit of a tedious process because it was first time writing some sort of communication protocol to communicate with hardware. So this is like the type of data that we send over to the sensors on the desk itself. So it's all in hexadecimal. And these are the type of format that we have to use. So if the format is wrong just by one digit or one bit, like, the whole thing will just either crash or the thing will not work. So this is the format of the message we need to send. So 30 is actually represent a random number that we generate and we use later for the communication. Then the address of the register, the functions to call. So the functions will have things like, say, a function to turn on the light, function to detect whether the user is present, function to move the desk up and down, function to get the height of the desk, and the data to send. And of course, the CRC check. So the CRC check is quite important because that determines whether your data and your whole message is actually sent correctly. So the CRC check is calculated using some arcane formula and a lot of other kind of C++ and C kind of language. So after calculation, how do we send it to the controller? Okay. So first, like, what we did was we scan for the peripherals and then get an array of peripherals using this function. Retrieve connected peripherals with services. So this one, I will actually retrieve an array of peripherals, which is your Bluetooth watch and all the kind of things around within your surroundings. Then we do a connection using this function, and then from this connection, like, we can start. There will be the connecting to the device itself. Then how do we send the data over? So this one is also a bit complicated. We tried using binary, we tried using text, and we find out that actually, like, we couldn't use binary or text. We had to use something called a byte array. So we had to convert our string containing a hexadecimal values to a byte array, then send it over. So this took us about 3 or 4 days of actually troubleshooting to find out what's the problem with it. So this one is like sample code of we created to, or what we did was we take the string, we convert, then we write some code to convert it to a byte array, then return it as a NS array. Then we send the NS array over to the device, then it can detect. We tried sending NS string and the kind of stuff, like, it doesn't work at all. Then after that, what we do is we get the right characteristic of the device and then send the data over. So this is the code that we use to send the data over to the right characteristic. So each Bluetooth peripheral will have the characteristic. Because the device, like, has a hard-coded right characteristic, so we hard-coded that value here inside this array. Then we just send the data over. We send this data, which is the NS data, over to the device. Then after that, after it's sent over, how do we get the response? So in this callback function, like, what we have is this function will be triggered whenever you send a data over to the Bluetooth device. So inside this function, we have to actually do some additional checking for the function. But wait, that's more. Remember this random tag here, 30. This one, like, is actually a random number, but we have to keep on checking that the response is actually the same as what we send over to the device. If not, we keep on sending over the data over and over again, so that once you get a response, which is the same data sent over, then it's actually correct. So what we have here is inside this update value for characteristic, we keep on writing the same data over and over again. So normally we write about 3 or 4 times, like, then we actually get the correct response back. This is actually due to some issue with the hardware itself. So it's not always first time we write, first time we get the correct response. Okay, so this is what we need to do for our code itself. Using the Modbus protocol, we just write the random tag and then the value to characteristic, then wait for the response, which normally takes like 0.5 seconds or less than that. Then we get the random tag from the response. Then if the tag does not match what was sent, we repeat again and again. So as mentioned, this one is normally takes about 3 or 4 tries. Sometimes if I'm lucky, I get it right on the first try. So once all this is done, what we did was we used the code. Then we are actually able to get real sensors data from the device. We can actually turn off the lights on the desk itself using the mobile phone itself. So we can also adjust the position of the desk, move it up and down, just by using the mobile phone and the interface. So this is the screen that we use for discovering our devices. So we have one button here, we tap on it. This one will actually scan the surrounding area and try to get all the various Bluetooth devices. Could be your watch, could be your phone and all the other stuff. Then we just tap on here, you actually do the pairing and the connection. And this is the screen where a lot of the Bluetooth code is actually done. So this one, you can actually move this slider up and down on the phone. And there's a light on the desk will actually become brighter or become dimmer depending on what you slide. Then these two buttons, you press up and down, the desk will actually move up and down also based on how long you press. So you press for 1 second, you move up by just a bit. You press for 3 seconds, you move up a lot higher. Then you can actually save the preset height of the elevation of the desk onto the phone. And then so that, let's say you tap on use preset, the desk will actually go down to the preset level that you save on the phone itself. So this is the activity tracker. So the desk site has a sensor to track your presence, whether are you away from desk or are you at the desk. Then it stores all this data on the sensor. Then we can do a sync up with the phone so that the phone will actually keep on polling the desk for all the data. Then it actually plots all these graphs for you, like your standing graph, how long has your light been put on, and your daily activity. So if those of you using like Fitbit, that kind of stuff, you all be quite familiar with how this kind of graph works. So this syncing will actually be done by the client, by the phone, depending on when the user wants to do it. And, oops. Okay, so any questions on the hardware part or the software? No questions?
Can you go back to the TCP part?
Oh yeah, okay, sure. Okay, TCP, okay. I see, okay. Yeah, because Modbus actually can do communication two ways, either through Bluetooth or using the TCP stack. So what I found is that all the other libraries that I have on the internet, on GitHub, whatever, all using Modbus on TCP. So it doesn't work for my use case, because my case, I have to use it on the Bluetooth stack. Yeah, so I could not use that code because the code is useless to me. So I just have to write my own implementation of their Modbus protocol to communicate through Bluetooth itself. If I can use TCP, it's actually a lot easier. I can just put in the code itself, but now I couldn't. So I had to write it from scratch. Okay, so any other questions?
So is the source code still Apache because you keep your source code?
Yes, but I may want to open source the Modbus Bluetooth part of it. Yeah, why not? You can talk to me about licensing fees later. So because this code belongs to my client, so I have to check with them whether is it okay to just to open source the Modbus protocol Bluetooth itself, because I find that there's actually no other implementation of it for iOS on whatever I can find on the internet or GitHub, whatever. Okay. Any other questions? Yes.
On the hardware side.
Hardware side, okay. The board they gave was not actually connected to the desk. So the board they gave is always you send whatever data, you always get the correct response. So when testing on the dummy board, it was actually okay. But when testing on the desk itself, sometimes the desk couldn't get the correct response. So I sometimes had to go down to the client space to actually troubleshoot and find out what is the problem with the board itself. So mostly it's all the Most of the time, it's actually issue with the sensor itself rather than the software side.
What's the difference between this and Arduino?
Oh, okay. This one is a very, very small version of the Arduino. Arduino, you can also use it, so you can put in the Bluetooth shield and then you can connect it using Bluetooth. But this one is actually just programmed just for the, just for the desk itself. So the functionality they have, like, it's only very limited. Arduino can do a lot more with it. But actually, I tried connecting to the Arduino, so it works for my software. But the client didn't want to use Arduino because they find that they feel that Arduino is not good for industrial use yet. So they find that it may not last if you actually keep on running for 24 hours, kind of stuff. So they didn't want to use Arduino, they use a Texas Instrument controller.
Your test is not supposed to work for 24 hours, but you work for office hour, and then the provider asks the guy to.
But you know, sometimes your boss asks you to work 24 hours, you have no choice. Yeah, that one I have to talk to the boss first.
Is price also a consideration?
Yes, correct. The controller itself, I think, costs about $19 for control. So it's actually a lot cheaper than the Arduino. Arduino is probably like $50, $60. So the controller is actually very limited in what you can do, but it's just good enough for what the client wanted for the desk itself. Any other questions? Yes.
Is there a loss of communication when the Bluetooth is being transmitted?
Quite. Because TCP, we wanted to use TCP, so but then we need to install the Wi-Fi shield on the desk. Then we found out that the cost of it is actually not that cheap. So we actually switched over to Bluetooth. That's when my problem came up, because I have to use the Modbus and create the Bluetooth protocol. So far, I never had issues where the Bluetooth get disconnected. Yeah, so I keep on checking whether the response is correct. If the response is correct, then I send the next packet over. So if the response is wrong, I keep on sending the same packet over and over until I get the correct response.
So each packet has like a hash?
Actually, it's not hash. It's just return a NS string. Yeah, correct. I never hash it because I don't feel the need to hash it, because we're not sending anything that's sensitive, like passwords or credit card information. Any other questions? Yes, it will be available, but the Indiegogo campaign is still undergoing. It will finish at end of this month, but they already hit the milestone already. So they're just waiting to finish it and then see how much more they can get. Then from there, they decide whether to maybe lower the price, or maybe after that, they'll get the Android version up.
There's similar smart tables out there that uses Wi-Fi instead.
Yeah.
Cost was the issue, that's why.
Yes, correct. And also the thing about Wi-Fi is that, imagine you have a big office, you have 100 tables, then you have 100 Wi-Fi connections. That's why one thing they use Bluetooth, because they said that it's actually nearby, so you actually don't need the kind of distance that Wi-Fi provides. But of course, using Wi-Fi would be a lot easier for me to program. Yes.
Going back to the communication
that
you mentioned, you got 30 and then which is the random.
Yes, it's like
correct. Let's say you have 100 of these stands in an office.
One
code, let's say one random tag is 30, and there's another stand somewhere in somewhere close within the Bluetooth radius that is waiting for a 30 command. So how do you stop the two from?
Oh, because actually at this point in time you're already connected to the device already.
Right.
So there's no way there's cross communication. Right. Yeah. Anyway, the 30 I can go up to 255 because it's all in hexadecimal.
Right.
But anyway, because I for 30 I keep on sending over, then I get the response back. If the response is not 30, I keep on sending 30 over again.
Right.
So there won't be a situation where I send 30, then I get back 45, then I send 46 over.
Right.
So I always get back the same response, then I send the next packet over.
So is it possible in the office there are multiple desks and somebody want to connect to other people, connect to other people, that's an people which you
actually can.
Possible. Yeah.
Yes, you can prank your friends if that you want to.
Install one for the boss and move on.
Yeah, if like you're sending it to your friend's desk and you just connect to his desk and move thing up.
When you're actually that's a good problem.
Yeah, then you move all up and down at the same time. Okay, any other last questions?
Do you have the link to the Indiegogo page?
Oh yeah, I have the link to Indiegogo page. Let's see, where is it? The link is here. Okay, yeah, it's not hyperlink, but it's this link. And so you can go to Indiegogo now, you can see that the campaign is still running until end of this month. Okay, thank you.